Hi makers, welcome back to YouMakeTech. If you want to build your own robots with your 3D printer, this episode is for you. I am very excited to announce YouMakeRobots, the 3D printed robot building kit. YouMakeRobots is a set of 3D printed parts, electronics and software that work together to provide a fun, accessible and affordable robot building experience. The STLs and the code are available for free. I added the links in the description. Very similar to Lego bricks, the modular construction allows you to assemble simple components together to build a wide variety of robots. It is easy to get started. For less than $100, you get all the electronics, no soldering required. The 3D printed parts are easy to print and print without support. The supplied code allows you to interactively control the robot from the command line. In today's episode, I give you an overview of YouMakeRobots and build the first robot with it. The robot we will be building is a Quadruped robot, actuated by 8 servo-motors. I show you how to assemble the parts together and how simple it is to make the robot move. I use low-cost, standard hobby servo-motors like the TowerPro MG996R as the main actuator. Each servo is enclosed into a custom-designed and 3D-printed servo box. The servo box provides a mechanical interface to attach the servo to the rest of the structure. I install a 3D printed horn on one side of the servo motor and a 3D printed servo pin on the other side. The servo bracket is attached with M2 self-taping screws. Servo brackets of various sizes are available as 3D printed parts. The servos are controlled by an Arduino MEGA board. In order to easily connect the servos to the Arduino MEGA, I use a MEGA sensor shield V1 from Kai Studio. The sensor shield simply plugs on top of the Arduino MEGA board. The power is provided by a 3S 11.1V polymer battery. As the Arduino and the servos require only 5V, I use a XL4016 DC-DC converter to reduce the voltage. After adjusting the output voltage of the DC-DC converter to 5V, I am ready to connect the converter to the Arduino MEGA. I can then connect the servos to the sensor shield using pins 22 to 45. Connecting the servo to the MEGA before assembly ensures the servo are correctly centered. Now let's pick the first leg. This is how a leg looks like upon completion of the assembly. First, I attach two servo brackets together using M2 screws and nuts. I insert a servo pin on the back of the servo box. And screw the servo bracket using M2 by 8mm self-taping screws. I follow the same step for the second servo of the leg. In order to build the POW, I assemble two 3D printed parts together. I attach a POW to the last servo of the leg using M2 by 10mm screws. This completes the assembly of the first leg. I can now attach it to the main body. After building the rear right leg as a mirror of the first leg, I can attach it to the main body too. Now I can build the second half of the robot as a mirror of the first half. Inside of the main body, I mount the DC-DC power converter. On top of the main body, I attach the Arduino MEGA. The two halves can now be assembled together using four M2x10mm screws. That's it! The mechanical assembly is complete. Now I connect the 8 servo motors to the sensor shield using pins 22 to 29, starting with the front right leg and turning clockwise. We are now ready to make this robot walk. But first we need to flash the Arduino MEGA with some custom software. Download the YouMakeRobots source code from GitHub and copy all the files in a YouMakeRobots subfolder under your Arduino libraries folder. Connect the Arduino MEGA to the PC. Start the Arduino IDE and upload the Getting Started sketch in the YouMakeRobots library examples. The Getting Started sketch allows to control the robot interactively using the serial monitor. Open the serial monitor and select a speed of 115-200 boats. In order to move the first servo to an angle of 45 degrees, we type move double dot 0 equal 45. By convention, the first servo connected to pin 22 has an ID of 0, and the angles are between minus 90 and plus 90 degrees. Positive is clockwise and negative is counterclockwise. To move more than one servo, we can group them into a single move command, separating each servo by a comma. To make this robot walk, we have to generate a sequence of coordinated moves. Let's take a look at this in slow motion. This sequence can be achieved with only 9 move commands. The starting position for walking is as shown on the image. First, the front right leg lifts up and reaches out, far ahead of the robot. Then all the legs shift backwards, moving the body forward. The back left leg lifts and steps forward alongside the body. We completed half of the sequence. This position is a mirror image of the starting position. Let's do the same on the other side. We are done with the second half of the sequence and are back to the starting position. In order to make the robot work, all we have to do is to repeat the sequence in loops. That's it for today. Thanks for watching. See you soon on YouMakeTech.